Hey Jess, really nice job helping them with the data structure.
Yeah, so we wanted to create a word class that has both translations for the English and Miwok of the same word.
Oh, and this is like the floor plan or the blueprint analogy we used from the last course.
Exactly, and so from the same floor plan, we could create many different word objects.
Oh, okay. Like this. This is a word object, which represents like the number one. And inside the word object, we have two string variables. A string variable for the Miwok translation, which is luti, and a string variable for the English translation, which is one.
And because this word object was created from this word class, it's going to have these two methods. So the getMiwokTranslation method,
which returns this string,
and the getDefaultTranslation method,
which returns this string. OK, cool. That sounds good.
All right, so from the same floor plan, we can create more and more word objects. So a word for two, and a word for three.
Oh my gosh, so many word objects.
All right, so in the next quiz, we're going to take a look at how to write this class definition.
Word.
All right, if you need help, you can refer to the simplified version of the TextView class that we showed you in the last course. So remember that we need to provide a constructor for your word class. And the constructor just looks like a method declaration, but the name of the method has to match exactly the name of the class, capitalization and all. So in this case, we have the capital T for text, and capital V for view, with no spaces, which matches exactly the name of the class, TextView. Also notice that the constructor has no return type. Now looking more closely at the constructor for the TextView class, we see it has the public keyword here. And this public keyword says that an outside class can access this constructor. So for example, an outside caller, like the main activity, can call this constructor using the new keyword and pass in this input parameter to create a new text view object. So note that you can create multiple different constructors for your class that have different input parameters. That way, any outside caller can create a text view object in a number of different ways, depending on what input parameters they can provide. Now in the next lesson, we'll see firsthand how you can create multiple constructors for a class. So as mentioned earlier, these private and public words are called access variables. We first learned about this in the last course. So they define who has access to these methods or constructors, or even this entire class. If a method is marked private, then it can only be called within the enclosing class. So if something is marked public, then it can be accessed from outside the class. So if the main activity wants to create a new text object, then it can, because this class is marked as public. And it also has a public constructor. And if any of these variables or methods here are public, then the main activity can call on those as well. All right, so here's a diagram from the last course, if you remember. If a text view method is marked as public, we can access it from both within the text view class or from outside. So something like the main activity could access it. In general, it's better to make the variables of the app, so those that control the state of the object, to be private. This way, you can expose the public methods that modify or access these variables. So these methods are called getter and setter methods, and they give you tighter control over how these variables are modified or accessed. So for example, if these state variables were marked as public, someone could set an invalid color value on the text view, and this would cause an unexpected behavior in your class and maybe even cause your app to crash. Now, on the other hand, if you have a private color variable with a public setter method, you can check that the incoming color is valid before updating the state. Now go ahead and move on to the quiz where you'll create the word class.